So this is, if I take common n minus l, then I can write this is n minus l is taken is common, so n plus l plus 1. So I can write that this implies that a n plus 2 is equal to n minus l, n minus l into n plus l plus 1 by n plus 1 n plus 2 a n. And this is the recursion relation. This we call the recursion relation because it can find us all the values here. Now if we look here, then if n starts from 0, then we will have a naught is here, and here we will have a 2. Then it is going in step of 2, we will have a 4, we will have a 6, and so on. If the start value will be 1, then we will have a 3, a 5, a 7, and so on. So the Legendre differential equation is having, it is a second order differential equation, and it will have two solutions. So it is having two series solutions which are containing the even coefficients and the odd coefficient, means it is containing a naught and a 1 is the starting coefficients, and one even series will come and one odd series will come. So the solution is the combination of two series, the even series and the odd series. So we will have to means to find all the values, the a naught and the a 1 are to be determined first, and then the rest all values can be found from them. So we will have to determine the values of a naught and a 1 from the initial conditions. So the initial conditions are, let me write again P in terms of this, the power series which is a naught and x to the power naught, so 1 a 1 x plus a 2 x 2 plus a 3 x 3. Sorry, a1x, a2x2 here, and a3x3 here, a4x4 here, and so on. So we will finally have an here, xn here, and then some other terms. Now we have already found the coefficients of a1, a0, then a1, then a2 in terms of a1, then a3 in terms of a1, a4 in terms of a0, and so on. So putting back those coefficients, let me write this in order that P of x is equal to a0 plus a2 in terms of a naught we have found plus a4 in terms of a naught we have found plus then a1 of x plus a3 of x3 and a5 of x5 and so on. Let me now put the values of A2 from the table of coefficients. So this is A0, and I will take this A0 as common because A2 will have A0, A4 will have A0. So here I will have 1, while the A2 was equal to minus L into L plus 1 divided by 2 factorial, and x square will come with it, plus the A4 in terms of A0 I have found, which was equal to L into L plus 1 into L minus 2 into L plus 3 divided by 4 factorial and x4 plus so on, some other terms, and then I will write plus a1x. So a1 will come, so I will take a1 as common, it will be x. Then a3 in terms of a1 I will write, which is minus L minus 1 into L plus 2 divided by 3 factorial into x3 plus L into L minus 1, now in here, but L minus 1 into L plus 2 into L minus 3 into L plus 4 divided by 5 factorial plus and other values. So we have written the initial, the solution to the Legendre differential equation is A0 and then A1 and other terms. Now this is this equation. Now we will see that this series, this solution actually converges. This solution converges for x square less than 1, while it diverges for x square greater or equal to 1. X square equal to 1 means that for x equal plus minus 1, this solution diverges, or this series diverges, and we will have to terminate the series. So we consider, for example, the very first one. Let's say we consider the series of A1. So A1 series is actually equal to x minus L minus 1 into L plus 2 divided by 3 factorial x cube plus L minus 1 L plus 2 L minus 3 L plus 4 by 5 factorial and plus some other terms. So now for L equals 0 and x equal 1, because we will have to show that at x equal plus minus 1 or x squared equal to 1, this series diverges. So this will be for any value of L. So we start the value of L from 0, and then this is equal to, when x is equal to 1, so we will have 1 minus L is 0, so minus 1, and here is 2 and 3 factorial, plus L is 0, so minus 1, 2, minus 3, 4, and by 5 factorial. So this is equal to 1, and minus minus become plus, in 2 by 3 factorial. So 3 factorial is 3, 2, 1. So 2, 2 will cancel, and we will have 1 over 3. Plus, minus, minus, plus, and 4, 3, 2, 1. So it is 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. So rest will cancel, and only 5 will remain, and so on. And we know that this series is diverging. We can do this by doing an integral test of this series, and the integral test will tell us that this series is diverging. So we proved that this series is diverging for x equal 1, as we know that x is equal to cos theta. So when x is equal to 1 equal cos theta, then this implies that theta is 90 degree, and this tells us that L should be a non-negative integer. That L should be a non-negative integer. So only positive values of L are allowed, and L is a non-negative integer. Now we want a solution. We want a solution that the solution for all theta should converge. For all values of theta, it should converge, so that it means when x square is equal to 1, that is x equal plus minus 1, and x less than 1, our solution should converge. Now we have seen that when L is equal to 0, the A1 series diverges. Now this gives us, when A1 series diverge here, so we will have all this determination, and then only this will be equal to A0. So P of x is equal to A0 only for L equal 0. And if I consider that if L is equal to 1, then A0 series is this one. This one is diverging. If A0 is equal to 1, then A0 series diverge at x square equals 1. And the A1 stops at A1x. So So we will have the P of x, which will be equal to a1x. So for L equal to 0, we have shown that at x equal to 1, our series was diverging, the A1 series was diverging, this was diverging, and we are only left with A0, because when L is equal to 0, then all these terms are 0, only A0 remains, while when we are having L equal to 1, then A0 series diverges and we are having L equal 1, so all these terms, all are containing L minus 1. So is here R were containing L, at L equal to 0, this all series terminates, vanishes, only A0 remains. Now when L is equal to 1, then only A1x will remain, while this L equal to 1, here L minus 1 will be with all terms. So when L is equal to 1, here all terms are containing L minus 1, so rest of the terms will be 0 and only A1x will remain, and we will get this value. So now in the case, when we will have negative values of L, what will be that situation? When we will have negative values of L, then it will simply reproduce the earlier solution, the previous solution. For example, if I take in this equation, if in this equation I take L minus 2, that L is now equal minus 2, then what will happen? L plus 2 is repeating in all this series, so the value which L equal to 1 gave us is A1x. Then when L is equal to minus 2, then this will become 0, this will become 0, and similarly all rest of the terms, and we will again have the P of x value will stop at A1x. So the negative values are actually reproducing the same thing, means the same terms, so they are just the repetition, so we will not consider the negative values of L, but only the non-negative values of this, because it is just reproducing the solution. So we will have to obtain the solution of Legendre equation. So in order to obtain the solution of Legendre differential equation, it's a second order differential equation, and we will have two solutions for it. One will be the even coefficients, the other will be the odd coefficients. So thus we will obtain a set of solution of Legendre differential equation for each value of L. For each value of L, we will have different set of solution for the Legendre differential equation, and as the negative value of L are reproducing our previous solution, so we will consider that L is to be non-negative integer, means only the positive values are to be considered. So is a ceremony. We are having the solution, the even coefficient containing a naught, the odd coefficients containing a 1, and our P of x will be equal to a naught for n equal 0, for l equal 0 we will have a naught, and p of x will be equal to a 1 of x for l equals 1, while rest of the series will vanish, and so on, and so on for other values of L. So we have, now if we set the value, if we set the value of a naught and a 1 in each polynomial, then in each polynomial is P of x is equal to 1. Means our even polynomial value is a naught, our odd polynomial value is a 1 of x. So if we set the value of a naught in a 1 in each of these polynomials at x equal to 1, so at x equals 1, when x will be equal to 1, our polynomial will start from 1, then the set of these P of x will be called Legendre polynomials. Legendre polynomials. These are Legendre polynomials which we will denote by P L of x, such that this P L of x from the Rodrigue formula is P L of x is equal to 1 over 2 to the power L and L factorial d over dx to the power L and x squared minus 1 to the power L. This is called Rodrigue formula. Now from this we can derive the number, we can derive different polynomials, the Legendre polynomial. Each polynomial is a solution of the Legendre equation. So we have selected that for the start of the polynomial at x equal to 1, our polynomial starts, so p naught of x will be equal to 1. Similarly, p1 of x will be equal to x, because a naught we have considered 1, a 1 we have considered 1. So as a naught is 1, so we will have from here that a naught is 1, so we will have p1 1, p naught 1. Then The next polynomial is p1 of x, and p1 of x is a1 times x. A1 is 1, so p1 of x will be equal to x. Similarly, p2 of x, p3 of x can be found with the help of this formula, and so on. So all the polynomials being the solution of the Legendre differential equation can be calculated from the Rodrigue formula. Now here the bar is L, and here the bar is L, so it will give us a constant, but here we are having x to the power 2, so this is actually x power 2L, and it will contain a variable as well.